Hey everyone, it's Matt here again. Welcome back to the channel. I hope everybody's doing pretty good. We got a good video here for you today. We're going to be talking about my trip to Detroit, Michigan, where I got to catch up with my good friend here on YouTube, Jason Zogage Trains, or JD Stux. And I got a chance to hang out with the Detroit Three Railers and various content creators. Let's talk about it. So this event that I was invited to was at Jason's home. We had a chance to catch up, and we had a chance to run a lot of different trains, both on his way out that I'm sure a lot of you guys are familiar with at this point. For me to get a chance to check out the latest progress that he has done, his roundhouse area that you'll see in this video a little bit, as well as just the overall progress of the way out, now having the upper level completed as far as the main circuit. As well as you get to see the backdrop work that he's done, and just a lot of fun seeing how that layout's progressed since I, if you guys remember, I was at his home last year for an event very similar to what's in this video. But the layout was in the very earliest stages where he only just had enough progress done for trains to actually fully complete a circuit and, you know, have a proper running session on. And it changed a lot over time. He's done an incredible job thus far. And it was just really fun just to come back and see how things progressed on there. But this video is also just a big highlight reel that I put together of stuff that I got to see while we were there. It was really fun. The Detroit Three Railers, Jason's club that he's a part of, and a club that I'm sure a lot of you guys are familiar with here on YouTube, or just if you're in the hobby in general. They're a pretty well-known organization, and they were some of the nicest guys I got a chance to hang out and talk with. They brought their portable modular layout that we had set up completely outside in Jason's backyard. And you'll see in some of the pictures just how large this circuit was. It was four full loops of track, consisting of fast track, and it was hooked up to Legacy TMCC and MTH and DCS Wi-Fi. So, and you could also run trains and conventional on the way out as well. So we got to see a plethora of really awesome trains outside, and it was just a different experience that I thought was really fun capturing and just seeing the trains in action in the natural lighting and elements of the outdoors, which is honestly quite rare and unusual to have trains that we associate ourselves with in the O-scale side of things in this hobby. You know, so it was a very different experience running trains out there. The sounds were a little different of the engines. Obviously, the smoke effects were a lot cooler to see outside because, you know, the wind was blowing everything around from the whistle steam and the chuffs and everything. So it was just really cool to do that kind of filming outside. And we also got to shoot some footage at night here, so you'll see in this video as well some nighttime shots of all the LED passenger cars and the lights on the steam engines and diesels. Just a really awesome time, and it was really cool getting a chance to talk with some other content creators who I haven't had the chance to meet up with in person before up until this weekend. So in this video, you're going to see some trains from some familiar channels. You'll get to see the Rambles, who was here on YouTube. Tony, it was nice catching up with you. It was nice talking with you and seeing your T1 that was in this video with your Ramble consist of the Reading and Northern passenger cars and the caboose. Really sharp set. You'll get a ton of shots of that in here. It was also nice to meet Bill B, who is a part of the OMS Railway. Great guy here on YouTube as well. If you haven't checked out his videos and his channel, definitely give yourself a chance to do so. He makes some really cool content. He's got a pretty awesome collection, and very knowledgeable guy in the hobby as well, and it was just an absolute joy catching up and talking with you, Bill. Definitely look forward to seeing you again real soon. You'll see in this video, he brought his 2102 Baltimore and Ohio steam locomotive that was absolutely killer, gorgeous to see in person. It was running on both Jason's indoor layout as well as the outdoor. It was really cool just to see that, and some of your Mopot diesels. That was very cool to see how much smoke those plumed out. It was also really fun just to catch up with some other guys who I haven't seen in the community. So I also got to meet Train Wizard Productions, who's here on YouTube and Instagram. He's pretty well known, as some of you guys know. He does a lot of the photography for 765, and his photography work in general is absolutely fantastic. He got a lot of cool shots this weekend, and I'm sure he'll probably be posting some things throughout the next couple weeks. Some stuff he captured, and he had his Chessie system gold plated locomotive with charging lights on it. That was a real joy to see that run at night, and just in the daytime, you know, the natural lighting just reflecting off the gold was really something, really cool. And you also see in this video my good friend Oscale Everyday, or Isaac. He brought his Greenbrier steam locomotive that was fully custom with different sounds. That's becoming a new trend in the hobby these days. A lot of people are taking MTH files and fully customizing them to be completely different. So a lot of cool whistles and sound effects on that. And you also get to see my good friend Johnny, or Automus, here on YouTube, who brought his two GS4 locomotives that are fully custom, one of which is a World War II all blacked out gloss finish one that was done up by my good friend Carmine, or Ferris on the Mall, here on YouTube. So you got to see that and hear some of the cool sounds that are on that model as well. And it was just a really fun time. I cannot thank you enough, Jason, for having me come out and have all of us get together at your place and cause a ruckus for your neighbors. And it was just a ton of fun just to come outside and be amongst some really great folks here in the hobby. And to me, that's what this hobby is all about. I always say I always am in this hobby for the people. And the friendships and connections I have made over the past year and a half, 2 years now, has been an absolute joy. And this was just a ton of fun to film and get together with some folks. If you want to see the vlog of this get-together, be sure to tune in to my good friend Automus, or Johnny's channel. He did a whole capture that captured pretty much everything that you would wanted to see that maybe some of the other guys could not film. A lot of us, it was just absolute chaos. You had Sid and Sam of Sam's O-Gage Trains, and a bunch of other content creators that you've seen on my channel here before. But once again, Jason, thank you, and thank you to the Detroit Three Railers. Absolute pleasure and honor getting to run on your way out, and just was a ton of fun. But real quick, I do want to talk about something else that happened this past weekend while I was out there. So let's talk about that. So real quick, before we jump into a lot of the video that I shot this weekend, I do want to take a mention to say me and my good friend Steve K, or Steve's Hobbies, here on YouTube. By the way, thank you, Steve, for taking the long drive and willing to drive me out there to Michigan. It was an 11-hour drive. It was quite a long to and from the event, but it was well worth it. But on our way, we did stop at a very well-known store here in the hobby that Jason has promoted for a number of years, and that was Stockyard Express. So they are out in Ohio. We went there on our way, kind of like the midway point before we got to Michigan, and it was well worth it. It was Steve's first time checking out the store, and as always, it's always a pleasure to go in there and see the very well-kept and well-stocked store. Clyde, it was great catching up with you, and seeing how you're doing. I know you had your hip surgery recently, and some of the other guys here on the channel, RJ, Jason, Sid, Chris, you guys paid him a visit a while back since he got his surgery, and he's doing very well as of the recording of this video. He's up, he's moving, and that's all we want to hear in the hobby, so it's great to see you doing well. But while I was in there, I was picking up a couple things that I had on pre-order. One was a pre-order item, and the other was the Nickel Plate Road Caboose, which I have right here. So this is a Stockyard Express custom run exclusive. So this is their center cupola nickel plate road high-speed service car. This is number 700, which is actually one of the cabooses that are still in preservation right now. And this is a killer car. I have one of these already in my collection. I might have shown it on the channel a long time ago. I have a Long Island Railroad version of this car. But this one looks actually better. This one has a little more detail on it. It has all LED lighting. It has the two sides having the red marker, has a smokestack up there, and the paint job on this is just phenomenal. The rivets are everywhere, it looks great. I love that it has the wood painted deck in between the rest of the car, giving a nice contrast. Just a really sharp car. And the other car I picked up that I'm very happy to acquire, I pre-ordered this about a year ago, last time I was in the Ohio, Detroit, Michigan area, is this. So this is their custom run that they did. This is their Sears Roebuck and Company car. This is the piggyback trailer car. This is now the third and final time they are doing this custom run. So Clyde had me pre-order this a year ago. These came out a couple months ago. Originally, I wasn't sure if I was receiving this car or not, but I sure enough walked into the store and he had my reservation slip on the box. So very happy that Clyde was keeping this around for me. This is an absolutely gorgeous car. If you have the chance, they still should have a handful of these available for order, or you can pick up in the store, as well as the caboose I just showed. So you'll get a little more in detailed look at this car in another upcoming video. But that was a really nice pickup, and I'm very happy to finally have that in the collection. So thank you, Clyde, and always a pleasure checking out and stopping in on your store. But that being said, let's get into the trains. Enjoy.
Yeah. Don't get me a little sweaty. I'm all nasty.
Thank you. Thank you.
So I really hope you guys had a fun time checking out this video and just getting to see all the really awesome trains that we're running, both between myself and all my friends here on YouTube, as well as the Detroit Three-Railers running some of their stuff, and checking out Jason's layout again. It was an absolute pleasure. I know he's been thanked a bunch for all the people who did attend, but you know, I don't think he needs to hear it anymore. I think he can get a good idea of how grateful a lot of us are to have the opportunity to have such an awesome friend in the hobby and somebody who really wanted to make this happen. So Jason, thanks for working your tail off to make this a very memorable event for everybody. And I definitely look forward to doing it again if the opportunity arises. It was just a really good time catching up and talking with all these wonderful folks here in the hobby, and it just goes to show why this is truly the best hobby in the world. That being said, I'll see you guys in the next upcoming video. I'm Matty C. Take care, and I'll see you in the next one.